Hello! Time for some Mean Streets on my old Amiga 500. I will try to finish this today. We'll see how that goes, but sorry. And I have been sitting here talking and talking and talking, and I forgot to turn on the mic. Yeah, I need to. Oh, yeah, I know why. Yeah. It's because this is a new layout I have, and I have on my startup screen I have On the mixer, I have a microphone, but on the play screen, I have the microphone on webcam. So that was the problem. Anyway, hey, and welcome to my stream of Mean Streets, which I will try to finish today. And I was just saying that I think I will go to a guy called Greg Call. How are you, Bruce? Yeah. Oh yeah, that's not working. 47, 53. Not place one? Oh, you should, man. This is one of my favorite games, although there's a lot of flying, as you will see right now. And it's just autopilot, and you just have to wait. That's the bad thing about this. The story is pretty good. Yeah, I'm good as well. Tired as always. I'm so tired on the weekdays. I was almost not streaming today, but after I ate, I just felt, yeah, a cup of coffee and then I'm fine. Anyway, so let me introduce you to this game. Now I'll put the box all the way over. Yeah, you see, I'm using the nice old Amiga here. I have it in my lap because that's how I do it. Yeah, this is it's the first game in the Tex Murphy series, the Tex Murphy series is a bunch of detective games. The later ones are full motion videos. This is the only one that was released on the Amiga. It was also released on the Commodore 64 and the IBM PC. Maybe Atari ST as well. Well, you're a detective, Tex Murphy. I got a. Yeah, I forgot what to say. I'm on a case. I was hired by a woman called Sylvia Linsky. Her father was a professor that commits suicide, and she thinks it's not suicide. So I will check this out. And it's set in a near future, or near. It's set in 2055, I think it was. And, yes, so far I found out that the company that the professor worked with, there's something not right. A lot of people working, professors that have been working on a project called Overlord, have been commit suicide or had accidents or got murdered. Like this guy, Greg Call, I think was murdered. That I'm going to now. And I think I should save. Let's save on. Yeah, let's save on zero here. And the other games in the series are Martian Memorandum, which was only released on PC. Well, the rest of them was only released on PC. And then there's the Pandora Directive, Under a Killing Moon, Overseer, which is a remake of this one, and then Tesla Effect, that was released just a couple of years ago. That's available on Steam. I will go through them all. Hopefully, I don't have the next game in the series, Martian Memorandum, yet. And that's in a fucking expensive game, and I only Oh, fuck, yeah. Shit. I was about to drink some coffee. What the hell? Ash. Oh shit. This is the hardest part at the end here. There. So you just keep coming. Now I can drink some coffee. Okay. Greg Call's apartment is located in Vallejo. It feels quite Spartan. Stocked with only a bare essential, I searched place carefully, but there isn't much to see. I move the dresser in the bedroom and a map falls to the floor. The map is of an area of California near Mount Shasta. And the navigation code. Okay, let's put that here. A, where was it? 8, 9, 11. Circled. If the law and order boys had found this, they would have taken it. Maybe this is where the laboratory is located, and I can beat them to the punch. I return to my speeder. Yeah. Yeah, and you really need to take notes on this game. You get names and you get nav codes, stuff. Okay. The disc sounded, yes. Many people in the stream like them. Couple of regulars that love to hear the disc sounds. Let's see who to go to. Sort of like now I'm in San Francisco and it's good to go near because it's so fucking long to fly. Let's see. Jorge Valdez. 4931. That's pretty near. Let's go there. I think he has nothing to do with the case, but it's always good to get rid of that name. Yeah, and right now I'm in the search of passcards and passwords, and the passwords I sort of have. It's chess terms, and I have 1, 2, 4 passcards. And I think it was it 8 or 7? I don't remember. That is needed. Right. Exit. This text is this not usual. You can talk to people and search places, but this is usually when there's nothing important. Jorge Valdez's home is located in an attractive housing project in Oakland. He comes to the door, and I notice he's still wearing his security badge from MTC. MTC is one of the companies that's bad. I ask him a few questions about MTC, and he gets a suspicious look on his face. They're keeping everything top secret. I know some Law and Order Party big shots from Los Angeles have been in the office on a number of occasions. One is supposed to know where. No one is supposed to know where they are from, but I overheard them talking while I was doing some service on one of the computers. I ask a few more questions. It's obvious he distrusts what's going on, but he isn't quite sure what involved him. All right. Like I said, nothing important. Let's go to. Brenda Perry. It's a very quiet game. But when there is music, it's very nice. I think I'm pretty close to the end of the game, or I shouldn't say that. Said that when I was doing when I was playing Indiana Jones and the Fate of Atlantis. And like 12 hours later, I was still playing. Right, exit. Again, nothing important with her. Brenda Perry's home is a small but elegant two-story house set slightly back from the street. The lawn has just been cut and there are fresh flowers in a pot on the porch. Brenda Perry answers the door. I ask her a few questions, but she quickly informs me that she just started at MTC about 6 weeks ago and really doesn't understand all that goes on right now. Ask her to call me if she hears anything that is odd or particularly right. Then we can just scratch down those two off my list. Now I will go to a woman with a nice name. She must be in the adult business. Lola Love Toy. 4, 6. Shit, is it a 0 or 3? I hope. Yeah, so the suspicious there's the Empty Sea and the Gideon Enterprises, which are the companies that all the professor works for. And we have the Law and Order Party, which is sort of like a racist. Well, they're racist against mutants. They don't want mutants. And there's a guy called Robert Knott, which is the head of Law and Order. And I found a letter signed RK that in a hitman's place. Let's save. Yeah, and then we have J. Sant Gideon, which is the founder of Gideon Enterprises and MTC. And a guy called Tom Griffiths, which is the head of the MTC. Right, exit. Here we go, nice music for a change. Lost Place is busy tonight with its garish red and yellow lights flashing in a steady crowd. Flashing a st and a steady crowd working its way inside. I get a table near the front of the stage. I tell the waiter I need to see Miss Lovejoy on an official matter. He slips behind the stage. A few moments later, Miss Lovejoy appears. She saunters over to my table and sits down. She looks like the kind of woman you could score with, even if you played your cards wrong. Alright. Alright. That's how she looks. Shit. What should I ask? Big Jim Slade. She's a hitman, I think. She had business with. Okay. Robert Knott. Time is valuable. Shit, I have no fucking cash. This a yoke? Yeah. I need to sell some stuff to get some money. What should I sell? I have a passport I need. It's worth a ladder. It's just 100. That's worth 2,000. Hope I don't need it. There's stocks. I can sell the stocks. Oh, yeah. Right there. Sell. And I have some more stocks. Sell. And I have a sandwich. for nothing. Passcards, I need those. Alright. Let's hope that is enough. Exit. So she costs money because she's in some industry. Let's see what she says about 200. Ah. He's the head of the Law and Order Party. He's quite the mystery man. He controls much of the action of the city. But he's hard to find. I don't think he's looking for publicity or notoriety. He wants to control things without actually appearing to do so. That didn't give me shit. No, not the park. Really? Fuck. Okay, 400, 450, 499, 500. Tom Griffith wanted me to find out if shimming? Who the fuck was? Yeah, Frank Shimming. That was some guy, yeah. But how does Shimming knew or cared about anything going on at MTC? I mentioned MTC several times to Frank Shimming. He thought the center was a waste of time and should be closed down. Oh yeah, Shimming is the head of Gideon. Tom Griffiths is the head of MTC, which is a branch or whatever you call it. I was introduced to Frank Shimming by Tom Griffiths. Griffith paid me to keep an eye on Shimming and keep him occupied. Griffith gave me a key to an apartment. That's just 4605. He told me to take Shimming there. The old guy was an egotistical bore who loved to talk about his favorite subject himself. Several weeks ago, I told Tom I was fed up with Shimming and I called the arrangement off. Spell it. Fuck. I Why is this so much money already? Even though I need this. Ah, fuck that. Let's just go to that apartment. Oh, wait. You don't have to wait. I just remembered I forgot to start a program in the background here. No big deal. Alright. $4,605, which is just next to this place. It's the Golden Gate Bridge, where the scientist jumped from. There, I'm just looking at. Must have been Adela Lang's. It was a woman who had information about another guy, but I have his address, so I think I was the last time. Hey, Nalle, my friend, how are you? Yes, Amiga time today. Commodore 64 tomorrow. On the Friday stream. I should have saved. I think I should have saved. Maybe not. I have a key. We'll see. Yeah, that's fucking. And getting low on ammo. Ah, fuck you. Oof. Oh, nice. I hope you score, man. Get some good games. Is it like old school PC games? Like big box, or is it just newer ones? I love the old box stuff. After I opened the door to the apartment, this is where Lola loved her, brought Frank Shimming before she had enough. Like someone else has moved in. Alright. Yeah, cool. Scandinavian design dresser, nice. The drawer on the dresser is a mirror and a jewelry box. Open. Okay. Alright. Women's lingerie. How do you say the lingerie? Yeah. From Fredericks of Hollywood, size medium. I think that's my size. Matches. A matchbox is approximately 2 inches times 1 inch. Open. Okay. A key. Okay, Nala. Yeah. I hope I'll still be streaming by then. Maybe I'm finished the game. Probably not. Well, see ya. See you then. A bus locker key. The locker number has been filed off. It appears that the station address is written on the back. Los Angeles, 5194. Back to LA. Bus. Penn stop working. Bus station. 5194. Yeah, and tell me what games you get. I'm curious. Switch. Standard light switch. What the fuck is that? Blood? Look at. Alright. Open. Look, I don't have the key. I don't have the key for that one. Look in the mirror. Look in the mirror and see the tired, haggard face of a down on his luck PI. Don't feel it. Oh, well, there's a button. Button behind the mirror. Right, on off. Press the button and a panel opens in the side of the holographic projector unit. Nice. A bed. Third, love bed with a red comforter. A small panel is on the head of the board. Ashtray. Should build into the and filled with cigarette butts. Look at the cigarette. Ah, camels. It's Big Jim Slade here. I've moved in, probably. Get. Okay. Box. The box description says inflatable companion. The loser's friend. Your perfect date at the movies, at the beach, or wherever you go. Warning, do not inflate on windy days. Alright. Should I open it? Okay. Oh, hello. A plastic woman in a polka. Oh, in a polka dot bikini. She rates a 9 out of 5. You seriously contemplate getting one of your for yourself. But decided another one would just clutter the closet. Ha ha. Another one? Get. Can't be removed. Move. Taste. Alright. I can't get the box. I got the... Okay. Cushion. Slumpy, let's move it. Okay, I got some more cigarettes. Cigarettes under the cushion are camels. Open, okay, nothing. Get the cigarettes, okay. Liquor. Well, a Russian vodka is inside the panel. Open. Taste. Alright. Artwork is an interesting post-nuclear piece called Rope Burn. You can't stand modern art, preferring pictures of horses or Union Pacific calendars, alright. Move, okay. And there's a switch. Look at... To reset the pressure... Oh. The table with rounded edges sign senses danger electrical field. Okay. It says property of big game Slade, touch this and I kill ya. Should I touch it? I don't touch the tag. Open the suitcase. Ammo, nice. Shirt has an extremely loud pattern with. Alright. Note. Note in pocket says Los Angeles Air Bus Station. That's what I have already. Nice. Okay. Get the note. Get the shirt. Get ammo. 50 rounds. Get the ammo. Alright. Mood globe. Antique Radio Shack mood globe with 20th century very valuable. Worth $2,000 on the street. Alright. Get it. Fuck. Which one did I save? Was it one? Shit, this is stupid. Let's load that one. Yes. And I think I saved when I was lawless, right? That ain't lawless place. Where is it? Yeah, it was. I don't even know if I need to. Ask her something. I need money. That's all I know. All right. I just asked her about MTC. I think that's what the only thing that gave me something. What happened? Ah, fuck. What's your offer, Frank? I didn't mean to. Yes, I'm not sure I really need to, though. I think I can just go to the apartment, but let's just. Ask just in case. There. Don't get electrocuted this time. 4605. Coffee was cold. Did not taste good. Save again here now. Zero. Let's put it so I know. Exit. And I need to shoot. Just walk a little bit closer. Okay, look there. Oops. Expand drawer. Let's look at it. Yes, need to look at it there. Matches. Open. Key. Look at the key. Get the key. Get the matches. Switch on off. Just for. Why not? Open. Yeah, I couldn't open. Move the mirror. And. On off the button. Where did that happen? Right, back. Bed. Let's open. Because it's funny. Get the box. Move, and there we go. Cigarettes. Was it? No, there was nothing inside. Take. I need to drink, but I can get it to sell. Art. Move the art. Off the switch, there we go. Look at that, but I don't need to. Mood globe. Yeah, I should not take that one. Oops. The book. Copy of the best-selling book, An Elderly Man's Guide to Picking Up Chicks by Dr. Ron Morgan. He's on my list. The visit. Open. Read a few pages and learn that elderly guys should suck on a few lemons before going out with young chicks. This drains off excess drool that could spill out at an inappropriate moment. That's a pro tip for you guys. Suck on a lemon before going out on a date with a younger woman. Yeah, let's take that book. There. Desk. A wooden desk drawn with edges. Binder. The binder has the law and order seal on it. Open. When opening the binder, you see that someone has written navigation code of NC5037. Los Angeles. Okay, what is this? Question mark 5037. Get the binder. Look at the ashtray. Where did the hit list go? Did I take the hit list as well? I don't need to take the move. Flowers, look at the flowers. Flowers are plastic. Move, nothing. Open. Get. Alright, they're still on the table though. Small cabinet on the door. VCR on top of the cabinet door. Open. Nothing. Right? VCR. Why do they have VCRs in 2055? VCR is a realistic unit with a high definition resolution as 25-year programmability. All right. Open. Only call it. On off. Move. And then I can get it. The television is a okay, on off. Turn the image on, but it's receiving no signal from the VCR, so nothing is shown on the screen. But on off the VCR. Move. Open. Right, panel. Oh, I can steal that, all right. Why did that sound? Turn it off. I know where that is. No worries. But the jewelry box, I don't have the key to that. Didn't move the cushion, the art I moved. It's already open and there's nothing inside. Okay. I'm not thinking I will go. Go back to Lola Love Toy. Yeah. See if I can ask her about the jewelry box. Button. But this. Think I did visit Sam Jones. Sorry, I'm just saying names you have no idea of if you haven't watched my other streams. Yeah, it's just a guy. I've written that he's something to do with a law and order company. I don't remember if I visited him last time or not. I did not make a note of that. Because I'm fucking stupid, that's why. Yeah, I need to. Haven't visited Ron Morgan, that's for sure. But yeah, I should go to the bus station. But that's in LA. That's a bit of a drive. I also should go to Greg Call's place. His lab. How do you spell you Larry Box? That's how it did. Key. Ah, fuck it. Yeah, I will go to the bus station in LA. Or I will just see where Ron Morgan is. If he's in San Francisco or not, I can't. Yeah, I go there. It's a bit of a drive, though. Damn it, how many pass cards is it I need? I think it's 8. And I have 4, I think. Let's have. I sort of know. I think. Know or think. At the bus station, there will be one pass card. This guy, Ron Morgan, might have one. So that's 2 more. That makes it 6. Greg Call has 1, 7. And a guy called Carl Davis have one, and that one is in a monkey cage with a gorilla. haven't been able to get yet. Let's save on the one. So, okay, being in the mountains feels like getting out of school for summer. The air is still pretty clean and the sky is actually blue up here. Von Morgan's cabin is on a beautiful piece of property near Yosemite. Is that how you pronounce it? It's decorated with a quaint homey items that make me feel like I've stepped back in time. I remember this. Standard metal desk with a single side drawer on the top of the desk is a fax machine. The fax machine is operational. The paper is jagged as if someone had hurriedly torn the last message away. On off. Move, no, open, no, drawer, open, it's locked and I don't have the key, fuck, share, okay, bookcase, carefully examine the bookcase, reveal nothing out of the ordinary, move, open, trash can. A plain trash can sits on the floor next to the desk. Wetted paper. Wetted a paper is a fax message which reads, "Dear Ronnie." Who the fuck is Ronnie? Oh, Ron. Ha. Huh. Stupid. Last night was incredible. You're incredible, but I need my nylons back. Yours always, Della. It's Della Lang, which is his girlfriend. Yes. Let's take that. Table. Newspaper. Death. Yeah. Open. Nothing. Move. Nothing. Get. Okay. Magazine. Casually scanned a magazine, Calculus Monthly, not understanding anything, of course. Each minute you waste skimming articles bring you closer to impending doom. Right, open. Move. Nothing. Let's just get it. Microwave breakfast. Food looks unappetizing. Okay. I don't get that. Couch. It's an 8-foot couch with a cushion on out of place. Yeah, well, let's move it. Alright. Handcuff key. Cheetos. Open. It doesn't seem to want to open. Move. Get. There's the nylons. Open. Move. Okay. Taste. All right. Let's get them. Change. Totaling $1. Nice. Handcuff key. It's a small steel handcuff key. Get it. End table. It's a small rectangle end table. Ashtray. Key. Get. the key. Okay. A photograph. Picture of an attractive woman in lingerie. Laundry. No, laundry. You frantically search for more, but find none. move. Open. Get. Look at this. A payment book for a beach house located near San Diego. 6470. Get. Looks like a very nice high definition TV. Looks like a might hide a small compartment. Open. Okay. Not a key. Looks like a key to a small lockbox. Normal wall switch used to operate ceiling fan. Yeah, let's turn that on. Because I want to hear that nice noise. Diploma is a master's degree from Stanford University. Move. Okay, open and get. Nope. Wall switch. This is the best switch for the gas log in the fireplace. Not yet. Moosehead. A big ugly moosehead stares back at you. There appears to be a latch under his shin. There's some cash. $100. Fireplace. It's a large rock fireplace with an ugly moosehead hanging from it. It's a normal looking gas log. But the paper is a fax message which reads, Professor, in accordance with our instructions, I have moved your computer equipment to your beach house. Side chair. It's just, all right. Move. There was a screwdriver. Nice. I need that for something. I don't turn on the fireplace because why? Feels like it will explode or something. Rug. Oh, good thing. I was almost on my way out. Then I thought maybe there's something here. Loose floorboard. Jewels. I get a lot of stuff. Get a deed. Look. And he has a property. 1710. Get that deed and some ammo. 50. Oh, fuck. back. All right, some progress there. We'll see what's close. But first, let's sell some of the stuff I got to get some more cash. Oops. I just want to see nothing there really. Passcode needed. Wait, can I look? Color blue. I think that I can sell that. Which list? That list. I did not. Law and Order hit list. Names not crossed off. Here we go, here we go. More. Harry Rice. Lola Love Toy. Tex Murphy, that's me. And Sonny Fletcher. Good job, Big Jim. I need to talk to you. Come to my house. Oh, I got his. Robert Knott's place. Nice. Zero, one, three, two. Right. Weird that he took that when I took the binder. Mood globe, that's worth a lot. Wait, that's just three pass cards. What the fuck? Green and yellow. Oh yeah. Right, I don't have the gray one yet. That's right. I got a lot of cash, though. Let's. Oh, yeah, I need to give it later. Where the fuck am I? Just see what's close. 6470. That's fucking far away. Seventeen ten. It's sort of on the way to LA that I might go there. Eight, nine, 11. That's the other way. Do need to go there as well. Seven. Zero, three, seven. What's in LA? Zero, 1, 3, 2. San Francisco. All right. Fuck. Yeah, let's go north. Because I think I will find something there that I need in LA. I have played this before, but it's many, many, many years ago. Maybe 15 years ago or something. I think I did play through it again that back then. It's from 90, as you can see, and did play it on the Amiga also back then, probably around 94. So how many years is that? It's like 23 years ago. Shit. This game is fucking 27 years. And it doesn't look like it, does it? And land. Save. A flight to the location near Saint Shasta that was circled on the map from Professor Call's apartment. The landing spot is deep in the forest in heavily mountainous terrain. After searching the area for a few minutes, I found an opening to a small cave. Go inside. The narrow cut in the rock descends about 100 feet and then opens into a large cavern. See a small light coming from the chamber on the far wall, and I decide to shake it out. This must be Carl's laboratory. Laboratory? Laboratory? Danger. Yeah. That robot. There's a stick. Large cabinet and faceted wall. Open. Using the 3-1 oil that I found in Linsky's lab, I'm able to get the cabinet open. Diamonds. Feels like I'm more like a thief than a fucking PI, though. I steal a lot of stuff. Voltage regulation control panel. Switch. Master power control switch. Turn the switch shuts down an inertial confinement unit, releasing deadly nerve gas into the room. You have 5 minutes to deactivate lock. The door locks if you want to alive. Want to leave alive. Oh, fuck.
Danger! Danger! Warning! Danger!
I think it was something in here. There's a button. Oh my god. I fucking remember that. Oh my god. Do I need to get out? Yeah, there's still time going. Should I just... exit and go back. See if I can do that. Or I just reload and go in and don't touch that thing. Yeah, now there's no time. No timer. Pull. Move. Get it. Danger sign.
Danger! Warning! Danger!
Again, what the fuck? It's pretty funny, I just took that pole and it's still there. Let's see again here. Yeah, loading, loading. Let's just get a key then. Let's see, so I can't left the things now. Desk, standard work, office work desk, desk drawer, open, it's locked and you don't have the key, okay, where did that key go? The fax machine is operational, no, okay, there's a key. Money. And ammo. Nice. 100 rounds. Thank you. Back. Computer. The computer won't operate without a passcode. I don't have the passcode yet. Medium size. Open. Okay. It's two switches. Look, light switch, energy field shield, switch. Here we go. Light shining down. Robot. Utility field robot over 20 years old looks to be in poor condition. On off. Oh, taste. On off.
Danger! Danger! Warning! Danger!
That's from Lost in Space, right? I will go here first. All right, flat file. Move. Open. Okay. Map. Look. Map of California navigation code circled 1700. The Lost Dutchman Diamond Mine. Oh yeah, I forgot to Harry Rice. Try to get in from him. $1,700. That's close to Ron Morgan's place for $1,710. Right. Get the map. Vine. Look at the vine. An extremely thorny vine. Move. Good thing. Shelf, look. That's the basket. Purple. But I don't know the code. Yet. Let's get that. Platinum unit. Move. Okay, control panel. I don't know. I'm like a maybe I should go out and then go back in. Go out and save. I'll have to do everything again. Yeah, let's do that. Just in case I do something and yeah. And I die. But how to figure out the passcode, but of course I have like a couple of options. Yeah, I can talk about tomorrow's stream. On Fridays, I usually. Why did it close? Okay. Where was that? It was here, right? Yeah. I do some beer tasting and I play some old school video games. Tomorrow I will do Commodore 64 and I will do some turbo tapes. Or one turbo tape, just see what I have. As one of my old ones from when I was a kid. And just see what fun games I used to play. That all. I don't get it. Voltage regulation. Should I do that and then that thing? Have some time, it's fine. Oh, that was it. Okay. I still have 5 minutes. I can check the computer and try to figure out the password. Purple Rook. Yeah, I think I found a list of like scrambled words, and all was chess terms. And I decipher them all, so I miss going here. I choose one. That was not it. Oh, fuck. Did not mean to do that. Okay, rook is not, stalemate. That's not it. What about knight? That was it. Purple, and that was fuck call. Call, right. It seems that the ultimate purpose of this microchip I've been designing is to control a person's feelings and emotions by implementing the device within the brain. This must be some sort of weapon which can destroy certain parts of the mind while leaving other areas intact. A victim could believe that he was fully capable of thought and reason and not even realize that he was under someone's control. I sort of knew that already. Okay, I got 2.5 minutes. Let's get out of here. And that pole I need in another. The guy who put stuff in the brain of people. What was his name? Carl Davis. His place. Yeah, so navigation. And he lives in LA, I think. Find his name and this mess. 37. Yeah, that was LA. So, Harry Rice also. Let's go to. The mine. Oh, that was far down, right? Then go here. I thought they were close. Pretty close, okay. Anyway, let's go. That is done. And let's call Vanessa. Probably, I have two sources that I can call or source, or help me. She's Vanessa, she's free, and then we have Lee, who is expensive.
Can't help you there.
And I think I'm so far in the game that Vanessa can't help me anymore. Golly. Why is Harry Rice on the hit list? You had it with me. Love Toy and Sonny Fletcher, which is a detective.
Can I help you
Yeah,
with
what can you
today?
help me with? Harry Rice,
Make me
make you
an
an
offer.
offer. 100? Really?
No
Three?
deal.
Two?
No deal. No deal. No
Fuck.
deal.
There.
Not for my
Okay.
back.
Autopilot. Yeah, this is a long trip. I will just use this time to take a bathroom break and get something to drink. So I'll be right back. And you can enjoy this And I see that I just got a fax. Which meant the whole driving thing I still have to do. Alright. Fuck. Okay. Harry Reyes live in Pasadena, 1231. My pen. 1231. It's still got pretty far. So I wonder if they kept this for the Martian Memorandum thing, all the travel. I hope not. Because that's the worst thing about this game. Because it's really fucking stupid. Where the hell did I go? I went to Ron Morgan's, whatever this is. Deeded property. The piece of property is in the middle of nowhere. There are no structures or buildings, and it's covered with sagebrush weeds. I walk around the property, but don't find anything noteworthy, so I leave. Okay. That was nothing. All right, let's go to, I'm close to LA. Should I go to the mine? A bit outside. But yeah, let's go there. And what else do I have? The beach, a house to visit. Harry Rice and Robert Knott. To go back to Carl Davies and to Carl Linsky, which is the dead guy that the game is murder I'm investigating, or suicide, and also the bus station, which I will go to now when I'm in LA. I will go. After this, I would go to Carl Davis because that's in LA. And then fucking bus station. Let's save every time. Golden Diamond Mine. I fly to the site of an old golden diamond mine that was circled on Professor Carl's map. I look inside the mine shaft and around the property, but it looks as if it's been abandoned for quite some time, nothing else. Fuck it. Carl Davis, 3720. I don't understand. It says warp, but warp doesn't do anything. Like, something I can, like, go instantly, but no. I accidentally turned off the autopilot. Should not play around with the keyboard. One down. Exit. Oh yeah, I forgot to say, but this is fine. Know where the alarm is. Guess I've been here before. Get the box. You use the 10-foot pole in the cave and drag the box towards you. Through the bars, the box contains the orange and some money. Nice. Orange. And that was Carl Davis. So now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 out of 8 pass cards. I've done everything else there, so that was it. Stupid. Bus station. 51.94. Hey, Patu, how are you, man? Liking some Amiga action? Beach house and there. It is. So what have you been playing lately, Patu? Didn't you tell me there was some game you were playing? Shit, my memory is not that good. Sorry. Maybe there was someone else who told me. I don't know. How I know where to drive? My notes. You find nav codes. And you drive there. Yeah. And I just put in the nav code and the autopilot takes me there. And I found a key with a note on it, I think. And the note said 5194. And I know that that is a bus station, because it also said on another note. And the key, and I have, yeah. And the key was to a locker in a bus station. But I don't know which locker, though. Yeah, that speedball, yeah. That's it. You was going to play, you didn't play, or... The lucky key was for an Airbus terminal in East Los Angeles. The Airbus is the only way poorer people can travel, and the terminal building is big, hot and dirty. I finally located rows of lockers and decided to start here. Used the key on about 50 different lockers before I found the one it fits. Inside the locker is a leather wallet. I open the wallet and find a black passcode and the word Kuro written on a piece of paper. Kuro, can that be a rook? So that's black. And that's Bosworth. What was Bosworth Clock? Okay. Oh, you do 3D models. Cool. Wrong side. Okay, I've done that. I think I was at Sam Jones. Yeah, probably was. Let's check out what the 5037. That's just an address I got, and I don't know where it's to. But it should be close here in LA because the numbers is close. 37. Yeah, so that's sort of what you do in this game. You follow leads, and the leads is the address codes. Yeah, I did. And it's modded. I'm having some problems with it, though. The thing is, I don't know if it's the Xbox or the my games. Because way back, I bought an Xbox 360 with a bunch of original Xbox games as well, but they scratched like crazy. I also bought Grim Fandango, yes. That was not that much, though. I think I made a pretty good deal on that, because I bought... The deal was I bought Grim Fandango and Broken Age. It was a bundle deal, and I bought them for 500 Norwegian, which is... what? Oh fuck, did I put my phone somewhere? I don't know where I put my phone. Fuck. Yeah, let's just for fun see what that is. Ah, okay. I was trying to Google with my Amiga. I'm stupid. 500 Norwegian in... euros. 54 euros. Almost 55. I buy the most of my games I buy on Facebook. I'm a member of a bunch of gaming groups on Facebook in Norway. Yeah, I have my Amiga in my lap and my PC keyboard just next to me. So the Grim Fandango I bought from a guy on a Facebook group. I was lucky with that, because no one else bid. He put it up for 500 minimum, and I bought it for the minimum. Like 54 euros for both of them. That's a pretty good deal, I think. They are complete. Broken Age, even unopened. The box is open, but the thing is, inside it's still wrapped in plastic. And the guy was kind enough to send me K240 for the Amiga for free with that, because he took some time sending the games. So I'm pretty happy with that deal. The Amiga scene is pretty... it's very small. The people who have Amiga games usually don't want to sell them here. I bought a couple of games from a guy that just lived on the other side of the fjord. I bought Monkey One from him, I think. A Street Fighter 2. Pinball Dreams and Pinball Fantasies I also bought from that guy. Other than that, my Amiga and Commodore stuff I usually buy from eBay. Like this one I bought from eBay. And going back to my Xbox, yeah. I don't know if this it's the games that's fucked up or my Xbox, because every game I tried, even the ones that didn't look that scratched, they were like, how do you say? Glitched. Or fuck, I can't find the English word for it. But then, yeah, I installed it on the hard drive, the games, and then they worked. Fuck! There. But the thing is, buying from eBay, the Amiga games, usually the shipping is cost as much as the games. But this one, I felt, when I bought this, I felt that it was pretty good price with the shipping. I think I paid, yeah, it was just the same. Paid the same for the shipping as the game, but yeah, exactly. That's why Green Fandango, I have been thinking of. I've been looking on eBay for it a bunch of times, and I found it with a DVD case. And I was like, should I buy it? Because it was just like £5 or something. But I wanted the big box, and the big box was so expensive. So I'm pretty happy I found this guy, and it was in Norway, so not expensive shipping either, so... fuck. Behind a painting? I hope I did save, right? Move. There's a safe there, okay. Not what I want. Fuck. Where the fuck am I? Oh yeah, I'm at the... question mark. Small switch. Okay. Hey, Bua, how are you? Thank you. Good to see you too. Although I don't see you, I read you. Trying to find the closet. I read you, yeah. open. Coats. Move. There's nothing. Shoes. Move. Nothing. Shelf. Look. Hat. Move. Fuck. Open. Get. Open. pad of paper. What's that move? I did move them open. Nothing. Let's get them. Let's get a coat as well. What the fuck? Fire. Oh, fuck. Ammunition. What the fuck? Desk. Where can the... flag move? Open. Okay. Get bookcase. A book. Move it. Open. Crazy glue on the toilet seats. Take that fucking book then. File cabinet. No. Move, okay, nothing. Open. Damn it. Garbage can. Garbage. Where can the switch be? Shit, 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 shit. Here. Toolbox. Plants. Secret, okay. Get hammer, mutant masher, move. Get the fucking hammer. My god, where else? Answering machine. Move. A key. Get the key. Move the fax. Fucking look. This is Slade. Clark's been taken care of.
This is Slade. Clark's been taken care of.
Get fuck. There's no printer. Move. Open. On off. Ladder. Look. As October will be the day to officially control the world, maybe. Robert, not. Get that ladder. Monitor on off, nothing. Move open, why not? Cabinets, the door. Open, okay. Memo. Fuck, I will read that later. I just have 2 minutes. Maybe in the safe. Ah, fuck. Open. Okay, I don't have the right key. Make sure to look. Open. Cash. Get a pass card. Gray. Great. Another memo, what the fuck? Oh, where? Try to open. It's already open. Move. Fuck, 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 fuck. 39 seconds. There's a fucking button. Twenty-5 seconds. Oh shit. Now I can breathe again. Okay, I got the grape. That's this is law and order place. They had stolen the gray passcode, so now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yes. So, let's just run Morgan's. I have left. Let's read that note again. What else? What, something else there? No, I took all. Something else here. There, a key. Pat the cash. Open. How much cash? $200. Yeah, I can steal from these guys. Oh, it was on the printer. Oh, there, cabinet. Officers are Robert, not present. Basil. And my pen stopped working. Again. Basil. Malloroy. Vice President, Security Chief, Melba. What kind of name is that? Melba. Weed bush. And Stanford DeMille. All right. I think I got everything here. Yeah. Yeah, there was nothing else here, right? Yeah, I already did that. Yeah, let's go. That was Law and Order. So now I should just go to Ron Morgan, get the last key, and I just remembered, I forgot to do something, and I'm gonna sneeze. Oh, fuck. I was just about to mute, sorry. I didn't have time. I need to go back to call Davis. I forgot to use his computer. Out about Stanford DeMille. Okay. Basil Malloy.
Can't help you there.
Melba Weedbush. Okay.
Okay.
Code. I was gonna check what time it is. It's okay. That was not what I can put it in then. 37:20. Incoming Fox. Stanton DeMille has office in Santa Barbara. 31. I think it's 99. And Weedbush. Ford City, 41:22. I'm thinking the Lost Dutchman mine that I found a thing for. Maybe that's just... wasn't there a game called Lost Dutchman Mine? On the Amiga? Maybe that's...
Sorry, can't help.
What? Did I... Mallory, not Roy.
Make me an offer.
Fuck.
It's worth more.
Maybe I should ask Vanessa again. Don't be sheep.
Look for my facts.
I have a lot of cash, so fuck it. Okay, when I get Norm Morgan's, then I have all the passcode. Then I need to find main terminal. This means I need to find MTC. And how did I find MTC? Because I haven't been to Robert Knott yet. There's a couple of places I have not been. Harry Rice. These three I just got. Where do I get my facts? Save again. There, incoming fax. Talk to Sonny Fletcher. No. SF. He's in. Okay. He's here somewhere. I also need to go to Bosworth Clark's place again. I think to check his computer. Was that destroyed? Fuck. I don't remember. Okay. Orange password, that was checkmate. Did I spell it? Yeah, should be CK, stupid. Am I? There. I have achieved minor success. The control microchip was placed inside the shimp today by drilling a burrhole through the temporal lobe. I was able to control the male's aggressive tendencies through electrical stimuli to the neurotransmitters in the brain. This action releases the appropriate amount of chemicals to tame aggressive tendencies. This test is an encouraging sign that several are alright. Have been able to manipulate elements of the ape behavior by inserting control chip in hippocampus ridge of the brain by using stimuli. Okay, this is just control area. The insertion of microchip into the optical cortex allowed me to control visual images to the brain. Electrical pulses of pleasure and pain produce corresponding. Okay. Subject was given a painful visual stimuli. The visuals must have been too intense. This action caused a massive seizure and gave the subject a berry aneurysm. The exploded blood vessels in the brain killed subject almost instantly. I have instructed to try several experiments on the chimps, all of which have resulted in total brain control, death, or permanent brain damage. What do they really intend to use this for? Instructions given now are to test the procedure on a human. I don't believe they are using the system for legitimate purposes. There is something devious in their request. I told them I will have no part in future testing of this control system. I feel they have not told me the truth about what they intend to use this device. Why can't I say it? I know the word. I can say it in my head, but I can't speak it. Legitimated. What the fuck? I'm getting old. I can't fucking speak anymore. Yes. Legitimate. Maybe. Yeah, yes, let's go to Ron Morgan's beach house. 6470. Is that? Sorry, my geography of United States is not that good, but that's the border to Mexico, right? Ah. looked up where Harry Rice, where that is. To do that, but oh, so Mexico is all gray. Save. Morgan's Beach House is located along the stretch of private beach on the Pacific, just outside of San Diego. The hot, dry Santa Ana wind lash out across the back porch. Outside, the pounding surf is deafening. But inside, it's strangely quiet. The air filtration system has not been turned on for a while. The room smells of stale cigarette smoke and spilled whiskey. When I enter the room, the door shuts behind me, setting off a security alarm. I have 5 minutes to turn it off before the cops get here. I remember this place. Can the thing be here? Base of tank, door, open, book. Fuck. I need something to get that. Because that's piranhas, they will bite me. It's broken. Fridge. Videotape. Top heavy beach bimbos from Mars. Freezer. Ice cubes. Shit, fuck. Console, lights, panel, burglar alarm, There we go. Panel. Look. Money. Those lights. Let's turn on the lights. There's nothing else. Yeah, there was nothing there. Why do I go back there? How do I get the pass card? Maybe I have some computer chair. Move. Open. Oh. Desk. Drawer. Open. Through machine. Move. On off. Ron, this is Della.
Ron, this is Della. Call me.
She knows something. Okay. Stalemate. It's the last. Get that memo back. I just need to get the freaking card. Can I melt? I was thinking maybe the key is in the ice. I took the small muted plant. Nothing. Maybe I already have something to grab that with. Should I try? Ah, fuck. Move. Fuck, base of tank, nothing there. Door. And it's already open. The the same. It's locked and I don't have the key. This is nothing. It's okay. Microwave and open, and there was nothing in there. There's nothing. Hey, Nale, welcome back, man. I'm stuck. What games did you get? Must be something. Computer, move computer, okay, no, open, okay, on, off. How do I open? There must be something. Chess book. Open. Move. Okay, nothing. Get. Okay. And move. Ah, okay. That's too bad. I need a key and I need something to. Maybe I can't get anything here right now. Maybe I need to. Go somewhere else. But I just passed the 3 hour mark, which was what I had planned today, even though I feel like I'm pretty close to the end. But I don't want to make the same mistake I did with Indiana Jones and think I'm close to the end and just continue playing. I don't have time for that today. I'm tired. And getting a bit hungry again. So, I will just exit here. And I will save. I will continue this probably next Thursday. Or this weekend. It depends. Depends on the weekends. I try to do like random stuff. That's my plan. I have had done a you can see a schedule down in the among the comments, I think. But yeah, I'm planning. Right now I will do on Mondays. I do World of Warcraft, which I think this Monday will be the last. Tuesdays, Resident Evil 3. Wednesdays, I usually take a day off. Thursday, I'll do this. Friday, the Friday Night Gaming, beer tasting and gaming. And tomorrow I will do Commodore 64 games and Turbo Tapes. And Saturday I just do random shit. This weekend though I will probably do some Mario 64. I need to finish that, and I will probably do some Breath of the Wild. Yeah, did I save? I don't remember. Let's save again, just in case. So that's my plan. But yeah, thank you all for watching. If you like this stream, this kind of stuff, give me a follow. he was it was me. I was gonna Google something and I almost stopped typing on my Amiga. Yeah, that's what he meant. But yeah, that's it. I hope to see you guys tomorrow on the Commodore 64 stream, or Friday Night Gaming as I call it. Hopefully I found some new cool beers to try. Thanks again, and see you next time. And I will just end this stream with some songs. Where is it? Here. Anyway.